Hey everyone, Professor Christina Stover from Cal State Long Beach speaking here, and in this video, we're going to be talking about what is experimental probability and what is the law of large numbers. As you see written on the screen, experimental probability is the probability achieved in an experiment. I know, riveting. But it's just the probability you get by acting out whatever action that is. And the law of large numbers, written on the screen as well, is the idea that the more times an experiment is repeated, the closer an experimental probability is to the theoretical probability. We're going to be using the Rossmann chance applet, and we're going to be having our experiment be flipping one coin once and just repeating that as many times as we want to get the experimental probability for getting heads. So let's go look at that. You can type in that link or go ahead and just search like we showed before. Again, it's the Rossmann chance applet. We're doing simulation based on exact one proportion inference. The probability of heads is still going to be 50% of the time because this is a fair coin. It's not biased in any way. The number of tosses, I want to just toss the coin one time and I'm going to repeat this once. And so we'll see what we get for that experiment. If I flip the coin one time, I got tails and I didn't get heads at all. So in the experiment, the probability of getting heads, I want to get one head out of the tosses, it's going to be zero. It didn't happen. If I did this twice, if I repeat this again, I got tails again. And this is just what happened in the simulation. There's nothing wrong here. We didn't break any rules. But again, the probability of getting heads here is still zero because it didn't happen. What if I wanted to show flipping this coin 10 times? I'm going to repeat this 8 more times, so my total will become 10. And overall, in my 10 coin flips, I got a head 3 times. You see that in red on the screen in the graph. So the probability of getting heads here is 30%, 3 out of 10. Now that's kind of close to 50%, but it doesn't feel close enough. And so we didn't do enough trials for this to be showcasing the law of large numbers. When we repeat it more, the closer we get to that 50%. Why don't I have the repetitions be a total of 20 times? If I were to flip this coin 20 times, I should get a total of 10 heads. I flipped it in an instant. We have 20 coin tosses. But I only got a head 7 times. 35%, which is 7/20, is close to 10. It's only 3 coin flips away. Let's have a total of 50 times, see if we get closer there. We are getting closer when we do it. So I'm going to repeat this action to have a total of 50 samples. I get 18/50, which is 36/100, or 36%. And that's kind of close to, 25 out of 50, kind of close to 50%. Just we're getting closer and closer as we go, but let's have a total of 100 repetitions. So we'll flip the coin another 50 times, see what happens. This feels much better. 4,700, so 47% of the time we got a head in this sample of flipping a coin one at a time. And that feels a lot closer to 50%. I feel more comfortable now with that. If you wanted to keep going, let's say you wanted to have the coin flip 1,000 times. Well, we'll flip that coin 900 more times, so it adds up to 1,000. We should get 500. We got 486, and that's pretty close to half. You can keep going with this and get closer and closer to that 50% mark. But just as we've shown, the experimental probability is just what happens in your experiment. It could be any value. It could actually end up being what you think it should be theoretically. In our case, it didn't happen that way. And we also showcased the law of large numbers, where the more times we had the simulation repeat the action, the closer we got to that 50% mark.